MBG's on quite a while.
And we are live. Where's the intro? There we go. So we're going to war with the UK tonight. We're bombing Gibraltar, just south on the south end of Spain. But if anyone's tuned in, we are. It's the usual Thursday night IMC conditions. As usual, we are in 1/16th mile visibility, launching off the ship. Out nice, I should turn on my formation lights too. Good call there. There we go. But yeah, we will be getting airborne, going up to the tanker first, and then we got a short hop, probably about 30 minutes, over to Gibraltar. We'll probably start seeing SAMs and whatnot, or the spikes of them went about 20 minutes after we break off from the tanker. But I appreciate anyone tuning in, and if you are good to go, Anthony, I'm going to go ahead and get airborne. Are you there, Anthony?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I thought I thought you heard me. Yeah, I'm good to go.
Oh, yeah. No worries. I'm going to go ahead and launch Cap 1. Tell 310.
Roger.
Launching Cap 1 out.
Allen 305 launching Cat 2 outbound.
Next time we see that ship, we're gonna be on it.
Yeah.
Well, oh man, I did my wipeout. That's supposed to be a Case 3 launch. See you back there in my rear view.
Gonna be rocket shipping right up there.
Yeah, same.
Oh, he's behind us, isn't he?
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start a left turn over to him. He's almost directly behind me.
Oh, good. There goes the visibility layer. Yeah. That's good.
We'll finally see again.
Oh, he's nice. He's nice being able to see.
It's through Angel 7.
Roger.
Sure, I'm gonna try to avoid this thunderstorm here and to fly through.
Yeah. How far am I? I'm only 2 miles. I gotta go straight up here.
Passing through Angel 16 now.
Yeah. I'm talking in game right now.
Oh, I thought I heard that, yeah. I got a visual on the tanker, I'm almost to him.
That's so weird though, Death Pony's the only one in here. I could have sworn I just heard someone talk in game, but maybe I'm going insane.
I feel like I've heard some phantom voices before too, not necessarily. But...
yeah, I could have sworn I heard that too. I thought I just heard it a second ago as well.
Yes, I swear to God I just heard it. I'm like, I don't think I'm going insane, but...
no, it's like even on stream, like we could probably replay it later and you could probably be like, that's... I'm 1.4 miles from the tanker.
I do. Good. 2.5.
Oh, I'm already nose cold. Nice.
Got you right in front of me?
Yeah. 385.
Look at that perfect spot for a nice gun blast.
Bruh.
Oh, man. I might be joking. No, I'm joking. don't engage. Once you engage, Doc, you might as well just eject right there. Yeah. No point in even trying.
Shit. I'm just a friendly dude. Just trying to fly and bomb my targets, you know.
I'm sure Ray. I'm sure Ray doesn't feel that way. just wanted to catch up, join you on the flight, and you decide.
Oh man.
Decide to engage.
And
him.
We had missile warnings. Like
We had good cause. We did. We had good cause to engage.
We try to, on our streams, we try to treat it as realistically as possible, like, where we don't, generally speaking, we don't engage people unless they're engaging us, or unless they're, like, being a problem, so to speak. And we'll give them however many respawns as we have jets. So, essentially, like, or say if, like, it's me and Anthony flying right now, and then two bandits came in, they'll get one life each, so to speak, you know, and then, like, we... They're welcome to continue to fly. Usually we'll eject them unless they say in chat something like, oh, yeah, acknowledge, like, knocking off or something like that. But they're welcome to rejoin, you know, and, like, acknowledge it or whatever. But we don't have the fuel to fight an infinitely respawning opponent, if that makes sense. The fuel or weapons, you know. It would be an immersion killer, I guess, you know, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And nothing personal against them or anything, you know, it's just like, yeah. Because I understand a lot of people join these servers, like, I'm guilty of it myself. I join servers without reading all the rules and whatnot, you know, and, like, it's, who does that anyways, you know? I mean, it's not like we have the rules, like, on the description either. You have to go to Twitch, you know, and, like, hopefully if someone sees them there, you know, they'll see it. There we have a little bit more ability to say more, I guess. The session description, I think you get, like, what, like, 100 characters or something.
It's not a lot. I don't even think it's 100.
Yeah. We're going to go ahead and, you know, switch is safe, no is cold. Tell them 310, switch is safe, no is cold, looking for 4K. So I'll be on the host for about 2 minutes here.
Copy that.
To be dropping these Mark 83s radar guided auto mode.
But you got
sure.
Mark 83s?
What's up? Yeah. I got two 83s and two GBU 84 series. Come on, Doc, get it together. What am I doing with this tanker?
I'm with my basic. I do every time.
What's up?
I'm doing my basic loadout that I do every time. My four GBUs and the two arms.
It's a good working loadout.
It is. It works good for me, so.
That's how the 310
states one day.
It is topped off. Backing out and exit stage right.
Be moving in here.
I gotcha. I'm gonna be assuming you're right-ish.
Roger. Yeah. On 305, just hit nose cold looking for.
Oh, dang, I missed out on chat. Alright, looks like I haven't. Good. Maybe I have, but it just loaded in. So sorry if I missed anyone.
05 receiving fuel.
Oh, donut! Oh, shoot, okay. Don't, I mean, just sharpening my sword. Oh, man. Yeah, donut's watching. My bad, donut. Okay, yeah, my bad. I just got a chat loaded. I was being a noob streamer and not checking that. I should have. Let's see if we got enough energy to mess around up here.
Bit 21 airborne.
Yeah. We're still at the tanker right now. We still got like about 200 miles or so. Not quite enough energy.
I don't know.
Oh shit, is Donut in
the
TeamSpeak?
Oh shoot, I'm not sure. I got him in chat over there. I haven't looked at TeamSpeak.
Is he watching the stream?
Yeah, he was in the stream chat.
Oh, what up, Donut?
Yeah, we're bombing Gibraltar tonight. Going to war with the UK.
Sorry, Doc. I'm having a lot of trouble here. Yeah. Don't know why. Still getting gas, though, so, you know, it's whatever.
No worries. You're looking fine. I was having a rough day as well.
There we go.
I'm going to go to your right dash and top off one more time if that's cool.
You're right, right dash?
No, left dash. My bad. Callie.
Okay, you're fine.
Being a new.
No worries.
Alright, it's a sloppy tuck under.
Your 05 is topped off. Backing out.
Roger.
Stage right.
Delta 310 is, which is safe nose coal, looking for about 0.5k. So I'll be on the host for like 15 seconds, and I'll be right with you.
Roger.
Delta 310 is receiving fuel. Whoops.
Roger.
Exiting and looking for you.
Roger. A little bit behind.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, I see ya.
Great night. Adding a little power. First stage burners, a little pull.
Roger.
A little less than 5 degrees nose up here, and a couple waypoints coming on now.
Roger.
Death ponies in their nods.
Oh, what's up?
I'm under nod.
Oh, I'm actually, I'm under, normal vision for right now. Should probably switch the webcam over here in a minute. Usually I try to fly, I always fly with the FLIR pod, you know, so sometimes I'll fly, with it on my HUD. Every now and then I'll, put on the nods just to simulate, like, putting it up to my face, but, I've actually tried to fly a Cessna 172 under NVGs, like PBS-7s. It was awkward as heck, man. Yeah, I did not like it. I like using them on the ground and everything, you know. And they're definitely useful in aviation, you know, but, like, I've also thought, like, during dogfighting, I wouldn't want that extra weight on my face, you know, especially if I can get it on my HUD anyways.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to dogfight with it.
Yeah, and, like, having... having something on your face that's going to be clunking into the canopy of glass and whatnot.
05 Eagles.
Yeah.
Fly down, fly left. Approaching center line.
I see the needles as well.
There's center line.
Yeah.
Wave off.
Oh, I'm gonna ease it out a little bit. It looks like we got some turbulence.
Yep, Brad.
About 30 minutes out or so right now. Target.
27. Yep.
Roger, and I'm slowing down to 220 speed.
Yeah. Roger. How far out are you?
I believe approximately 55 miles.
Roger.
We'll actually be there once we level off a little bit sooner, probably about, because we're pushing about 8.4 miles a minute right now. We'll probably be going up to about 9.
Yeah.
Estimating about 25, 24 minutes out. Excuse me. How's your fuel look?
17.4.
16.5.
Jesus.
Yeah, somehow you always,
yeah.
I always end up with less. I'm gonna have to check 301 or 31. Oh yeah, I think, wait a second. Yeah, okay, I'm in Blackout's jet. 301, Cali.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, you probably don't even see it as a, you know, because I don't know if you have all the textures.
No, I literally only have two of the textures, mine and yours.
Is K-Bong tech? I don't think he's tech back.
During the server before, I don't think he was. But don't quote me on that. We'll just have to.
He's not on our, IFF list.
Alright. Probably not, the level us off at, 3.6.
Oh, yeah. My bad.
You're fine. I didn't even pay attention.
Under control.
I wasn't even paying attention to when we started, contrailing.
Yeah, I mean, either I was, opening up Excel.
There we go. Using the drive. Pilot induced oscillations there.
It might work though at barrel hold.
Yeah, just put it on. It's tweaking a little bit right now, but it should self back.
Yeah, it's not TAC packed. F-16D substitute by L-39.
Iris F-16.
Yeah.
So weird that they would, like, their tag for it is 666. be right back down.
Yeah. Updated ETA about 21 minutes.
Right.
We'll probably be getting spikes here in about 12 minutes. We're going to start out looking at engaging with harms here in about 12 minutes.
Okay, I'm about halfway between both destinations.
Yeah.
I'll let you guys surprise them and I'll come sweeping. Yeah, I got a spike. That's a 3-1 spike.
Throttle's still good. That's my joystick a little bit.
Yeah.
Alright, cool.
Damn.
Got a 16.8. Nice. Gonna add a 0.0 when we get there.
Oh, what's that?
Got a 16.8 when I get there.
Oh yeah, 15.9 at the moment for me.
Roger.
I'm gonna go ahead and darken my aircraft.
Roger. Oh, that's your spike. I'm like, what the fuck?
Huh?
I was getting your spike.
Oh. Huh. Oh, okay, wow. Okay, my nose is hot. Jesus. Alright. Yeah, nose cold. Okay, so, being a noob. I'm surprised you're getting it, though, a line of rest, though.
Yeah, I was getting it.
Yeah, it was a line of rest with only a 90-degree sweep on air-to-ground mode. Turn into a dark night.
Better for us when we get back to the ship.
Yeah. It's actually pretty true.
Aiming for the one spot where you don't see lights.
light us up initially with their primitive radar. Only, I think there's one jet if we're close enough together.
Big mistake. They can try, but they will not succeed.
Not that it would matter if they knew there's two, but
they're gonna get demolished either way, so.
There we go. 0.91 Mach. Nice.
You see that the fastest RC jet in the world? Did I ever show you that video?
I don't think so.
You can go 462 miles an hour.
Alright. Shit, that's Mitchell. Definitely if you're running, baby.
Wait, what's up? Yeah. You got a missile after you, you said?
Hey, bro.
Oh, oh damn. Shit.
Missed. Fuck.
Oh, damn. Did it get you?
Yep.
Shit.
Right engine.
Oh, you're still flying?
Yep.
You vade back out to the freaking, what is that, yeah, northwest. Unable. Duck behind that mountain if you have to.
Unable. Control. Trying to get secondary control.
Oh, shit. So you're, like, totally on fire? Oh, damn. Yeah, it's going to crash him into the ground eventually.
Yeah.
Eject. Yeah, you're going to have to eject. Down. We'll have to do like an Arma 3 stream. Or, where we go rescue a pilot.
Yeah, I just had to do that a couple times for me, so. But you know, my guy's an idiot every time. And I'm just looking at a fucking wall in the corner, not even watching the doorway, making sure, you know. No one comes in there looking for me. Just, and they're looking at the wall, playing with my thumb. Right, Doc?
That's bummer.
Damn. Yeah, it is a feisty, they're feisty tonight.
I looked up the SA-2 missile launcher in real life. Those things are fucking big.
Yeah, huge. They're telephone poles, essentially, that come after you.
Yeah, I never knew why you said telephone poles, but now I know, because they are freaking huge.
Yeah, it's like a Saturn V rocket coming after you.
That's it. They slung two at me. I got the first one out, second one hit my number two.
Yeah. Jerks. That one goes. Yeah, jerks. We're coming in for a vengeance strike.
Okay.
We are 112 miles out.
Almost there.
The good thing is though, when it spawned you back in, as long as you had your loadout on, it spawned you in with a full loadout, right?
Yeah. Yep, sure did.
The good news is though, is once you get on the ground, you'll be able to, like if you ejected, you'll be able to have that emergency locator beacon or whatever you had set off, we would be able to track you pretty quick.
Nice.
Send out a...
Just help us out. Walk right up to one of the missile launchers and just punch it repeatedly. Should do some damage.
Use my hatchet.
I would recommend distancing yourself. Like, it probably happened pretty far from the missile site anyway, so you probably has a pretty good chance to escape and evade as it is. Run into a local town, take a bus out of town or something, who knows.
They had a couple radars about 25 miles out.
Okay.
This is what it showed. I got a couple ground hits.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Cool.
You hit him with HARMS?
No, I'm just doing snake eyes today.
Ah.
I'm gonna get close and punish.
Only thing I wish they put in on the 8. In all honesty, I don't want to say it kills it for me, but it kind of does. There is no gun effect at all that it bothers me so much.
Oh, on the Iris A10?
Yeah, there's no gun effect at all.
It's 100
miles.
What do you
mean gun effect? Oh, you mean like drag?
No, like, you know how you look at a video of like an A10, you see like the smoke fly off the, or like the...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was surprised to see the fire from you last night for your guys' view. Yeah, because I can't see it on mine.
Yeah, we, yeah, that's what I saw you, coming in for your runs, and I was watching you.
I think I have, like, a beta test version of the A10 still, though. So that's why I was showing, like, that weird effect, you know, when you would shoot the gun, where it would, like, light up a lot. But...
Oh, really?
Yeah. But, But yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah, I'd probably almost say, though, that, like, no gun effect might be better than that one. One of the things that I remember is Iris A10 one of the ones that has the guy that grunts as you pull G's?
Yes.
Yeah, he does.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, that annoys me so much. I can make my own grunting noises. I can breathe on my own by virtue of me being alive and playing this game. I'll already have built-in breathing noises.
Yeah. I'm going to start getting acquired here. Put it in TO mode. Get ready to,
excuse me.
86 miles out. We're going to start getting spiked here.
We're going to go ahead and split out to the left a tad bit. Let him over here. I'm going to actually go nose hot.
No wing wave for your boy?
Yeah, I'm going to MacGruber this one. I'm just going to let him over here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could be like MacGruber, Death Pony, just walk up to the missile, just take the warhead right out. Or I don't even know.
Yeah, walk away.
Yeah. You ever seen that movie?
Yeah. It's awesome.
Fuck it. I just saw it the other night. Doc was telling me about it. It's so funny.
Spike Sam, 12 o'clock.
Yep, Spike Sam, fall back.
Oh, cool, I just locked it.
Oh, just lost it.
I still got it.
Oh, I got it back. There we go.
I'm going to accelerate a little bit, get ready to fire off a harm here. I'll fire on at 70 miles.
Roger. I'm going to plug all these in very quickly.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got 3-6-0-7-2-3-6.
Mach 1 now.
5-2-0-4-3-9. It's in the west. Elevation is 0 feet. Look at that.
Nice. Talent 3-1-0, Magnum.
Roger.
I'm gonna also lock up the one to the far south. I'm gonna come off to the right a little bit out in front of ya.
I'm hitting shift R, but it's not transitioning to the next one. Why is it not?
There might be two right next to each other. If you keep hitting shift R, you know?
Yeah, I am. I am. It's still sitting on number 4.
Yeah, I got another one locked up, off to the...
Alright, I'm just gonna hug him. Magnum.
Talent 3-1-0, Magnum.
Go.
And I'm gonna reduce power and come back to ya.
Roger.
We're gonna be on your right mesh now.
Copy that.
Or actually, no, I'll be returning back to the left mesh. It looks like I'm still on your left side.
You're fine. I not switch between these targets? Is there, if I hit shift R, it should cycle through all of them, no matter if I'm on the last one or not, right?
Yeah. Great, you can try finagling it too, though. Sometimes I come out of that mode and, like, get control of you.
Right, okay.
I'm gonna take a look at this, arm. Yeah, I'm gonna climb in a slot. Pretty long ways to go.
Still can't lock up the other ones for some reason. This is, very weird.
Very weird. Take a look at this dude. See, a little bit off to the left.
Ah, there we go. There we are.
I think my line of sight, I can't see him.
Yeah, that's. I just picked up the spike from the other one. That's probably why.
You go ahead. EXP2.
Grab this other guy. Roger. 3608337. There. Or. 0-2-2-8. Free agent. Who is that? That name sounds so familiar. Who is that? Free agent 274.
I don't think that's agent. That is that who you're thinking of?
Oh, it might be.
It might have been eight, like, yeah.
That's probably who I'm thinking of, but it's not him.
Oh, look who I just found. I just found a ton of them, man. There's like three of them right in the same area.
Yeah, there's four of them up, I think. I'm getting four of them. Four spikes.
Okay,
your harm just hit the one. Yeah, your harm just hit the one mine's
nice.
Going for. 305. It's the target area. And we'll lock this guy up. 60835. Go. Yeah, I was gonna say, there's definitely a couple of them in the same area because the coordinates are really, really similar.
Oh, yeah.
And 305, Magnum.
Nice. I'm at 37 nautical miles right now. I'm getting ready to do a JNAM strike. 2,000 pounder mile. About 3 minutes out from weapon release.
After that,
get my.
I keep crashing. I can't get low enough.
Oh, what's up?
I keep crashing. I can't get low enough.
Oh damn.
It's bad.
Yeah, that happened. Coming to the left here, Doc. Take a look at my second arm. See
Roger.
Where that one goes. Yeah, getting ready to grab my JNAMs here. Can get it on the right waypoint, and I have a blind spot on my radar. Should be in the right area, so I shouldn't have a problem with that. Go ahead and go full burners here.
Make my turn in right now. Should I get lit up here?
Yeah, I'm gonna get lit up too. I'm 26 miles out.
Oh,
I still have 40.
30
yeah, I still
miles.
Have 40 seconds. I still have 40 seconds on my release, so. But we'll see how this goes.
Roger.
Oh, there it's locking me. No missile up yet.
Which direction are you gonna evade to?
The south.
Right.
Southwest. It's not locking me anymore. 305, it's the target area.
Nice! Nice! Oh
yeah,
shoot, now I got another one.
Bomb's gone. Yep, it's locking me now. Missile up. I'm dipping out to the southwest.
Yeah. My supersonic 20 seconds out from weapon release.
Roger.
Shit, I got a lock too.
Oh shit, there's three missiles up after me.
310, bomb gone.
Oh, you're even kidding me, bro.
Did you get hit again? starting on me quick. Holy shit. Oh man, that was so fucking close, dude. 305 is safe. Holy Christ, man. Man, we gotta look at the tag view for that one, Doc.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, no kidding.
Did you come pretty close too?
I think so. I'm not sure. I'm trying to zig and zag.
Yeah, that one was turning on me real quick. There it goes. It's spiking me again. No luck. I'm currently climbing away from the target. I'm at 15, Angels 15 right now. Lost a lot of altitude trying to gain energy in that.
Down to Angels 32. I need to climb on out of here.
Roger. I'm going to take a look at my bombs here, see what they go for. Oh, is that... No,
Talent 310 hits in target area. Aw, oh, dang. That's my last connection, I'm guessing.
Yeah, I think so, because you just left the game.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I got yours, like, Doc.
But yeah, I'm still climbing. I'm evading. Not quite safe, according to my RWR yet.
Roger. I'll stay away for now, then. I'm still climbing away.
Nice. Okay, 310 safe.
Roger. I'm gonna go ahead and lock the second guy up, coming from my last two.
Roger.
I didn't get one of the sites totally acquired or get the coordinates for, so I'm just gonna drop my last two on this one that I know.
Yeah.
I see your contrail up there.
Yeah, I'm Angels 35 right now.
Roger. Oh. I just got a missile warning out of nowhere.
Yeah, that's I think it's a residual one. So
probably from the one that you just evaded.
Yeah. Because I'm getting it too. I think our RWR is just picking up. It's when you see an X, that means it's just an IR, or it means it's just looking at a rocket booster or something like that, or it's not getting a necessarily active emission from it.
Yeah, it's a flashing X. What does the flashing X mean?
Usually IR. It's being detected via... Oh, yeah, I just saw a freaking SAM site there.
Alright, I am 3 minutes out from weapon release, but I'm gonna go ahead and climb way up here.
Oh, there is something over there.
Yeah, there is. I'm getting a spike. I'm gonna see if I can see him on my radar. Nope, I got a deep blind spot.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I got a complete blind.
Yes.
Radar.
Tonto 310 is off to the south.
Roger.
310 is engaged offensive.
That is not spiking me anymore. Hoping within a minute and a half I can get these two bombs gone. If they're close enough together, I'm hoping, because the spike is coming from about the same direction where my designator is, so.
Escaping off to the west right now.
Oh, it's locking me.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn away. I'm gonna turn to like 100 degrees away, but I'm still gonna gain some altitude here, and it's not locking me anymore.
Same.
Alright. I'm currently off to the northeast.
Roger, I'm off to the west right now.
Copy. I'm still climbing through Angels 2-6. As soon as I get up to about Angels 3-8, I'm gonna go real high. I'm probably gonna go up to about 4-0. I'm gonna turn back in and release these bad boys.
I just got a spike again.
Roger.
How's your fuel look?
Fuel's looking fine. 11.5.
Nice. I'm at 11.4 myself.
Oh, 11.4, yeah. I am 11.4 myself, yeah.
We're almost even on fuel.
It's
a possum group.
Impossible. I haven't gotten a spike yet, so hopefully when I turn back in, things will be ready to go.
I'm probably up to about angels 40, and then I'm going to turn back in for like 50 miles and hopefully get a nice long look at that area.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm only going to turn in from about 30 miles, but
yeah,
it should be alright.
It starts locking usually around 28 or so.
Yeah, I'm 24 right now, but it's not spiking me and I'm flying away from it, so I turn back in at about 30.
I'm getting a good spike from off to the west, so I'm thinking that might mean I have line of sight on him.
Yeah, it probably does. I'm not even getting a spike right now, so. I totally forgot that Gibraltar's surrounded by mountains.
I'm gonna be turning back in now.
Roger. Passing through Angels 37.
Same. 37.5 myself. Try to somewhat turn in somewhat quickly so that way I
gotta
traverse too far to the south as I'm turning in. Right,
still haven't gotten a spike. Timer's counting down pretty quick at Angels 3. Got your spike.
Yeah.
A minute till pickle or bomb release, weapon release, whatever you want to say.
Yeah. Alright, did you find them on your radar?
I didn't, but I have the coordinates for three of them, and I'm just going to drop it on the one I did not drop it on, and the one that I know my farm did not hit. So I'm hoping this is the one that's still active that I'm about to drop my bombs on. Yeah, I'm going to pickle two of them, and then I'll just circle the area, waiting for you to be done.
Yeah.
Nope, it's spiking me, but I'm only 10 seconds from weapons release. Oh, it's lost. There, it's not spiking me. Alright. 305, bombs gone. Nope, bombs are gone. I'm boogieing off to the west.
Roger. I do not see him yet on my radar.
Roger. I'll let you know what these bombs do, see if I get some good hits on it. I'm at Angels 4-1, just to keep my energy up. I'm going to drop down to about a 3-7.
Right.
I'm off to the west. And I'm, oh, missile's up.
Maybe he's the one. Is he the one way out to the south, maybe?
Wait, F1? Why do I have an F1?
That's probably my spike.
I have an F1 missile.
Well, it's definitely not a friendly missile.
I swear to God, it says F1. That's
exactly. Fly away from it and treat it just like a regular one missile.
Oh, I am, Doc. Don't worry. I'm not messing with it.
Okay, he's like right in front of me right now. Okay.
305 is safe.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
310 is going to be back off to the south.
Roger. I'm off to the north right now. I'm flying just away from it for now. I'll let you know what my bombs do here.
I think he's going to be the furthest guy to the south. Like, if we look all the way to the south into that island, or the peninsula.
Yeah.
That's why I'm turning back to the southwest right now.
Alright. 305 hits in target area. I think that was one that was already hit, though.
Yeah.
Fortunately.
No worries. All right. I had a JDAM, and I think I might know where this knucklehead is.
Yeah, Roger. I'm just going to hang out about 30 miles away, north of the site.
Roger.
I'm going to be circling at Angels 3-5. My fuel is kind of low, at 8.5.
Okay. That's a
Roger. I'm gonna get up to good altitude here and see if I can conserve some fuel.
Once I get to about 40 miles again, or actually probably 45, we'll be turning back to the south again.
All right, ready.
Or not back to, but back to the northwest.
Oh, that's why that's only left. He just said something. Crap, my controller battery is dead. No charger with me. Catch you in a day.
Oh, yeah. I totally did not see that.
Yeah, I didn't even see it either. Alright, there's Angels 3-4. I'm just gonna put it in the minimum stage burners and fill out for now. Is there a way I can put a waypoint down right where I am? What is it, Mark 1?
Yeah, Mark 1. Start circling it. I would do it sufficiently far away, because if you're at like Mach 0.8 or something like that, your turning circle at like Angels 38 is going to be very, very big.
Yeah.
I'd fly back towards the ship for like maybe like 50 miles or 60 miles or so.
Alright, roger.
Because your turning circle is going to be like at least like 30 or 40 miles, possibly.
Right. Alright, I gotcha. Roger.
Depending on your airspeed, of course.
Right.
I'm turning back in for the SAM site now.
Roger.
I should, I didn't spot him on my radar yet, but I think I know where he's hiding.
Alright. Sounds good.
Possibly. We're gonna see. Should be good still.
Yeah.
Maybe.
I should. Yeah, I'm hoping I don't falter.
Oh, fuck yeah, we do have some scary conditions tonight, don't we?
Yep, we are. We got the poo. How far out are you from weapon release?
Shoot, like 3 minutes.
Roger.
I've not found him yet, though. It was not where I thought he might be.
Found the airport?
Yeah.
The good size?
Two miles.
do. Ship him. I'll be right back.
Roger. Not seeing the sky. Or how many coordinates do you have? Or like, which one do you think might be it? If you had to take a guess.
Oh man. All right.
Or do you think you'd give me one that you don't think you've hit?
All right. Yeah, I'll give you one that I don't think I hit. I'll basically just give you the one that I didn't drop any bombs on. All right.
One second. Yeah, I'm getting a safe position. UFC. Okay, I'm ready to copy.
Oh, my bad. Give me one sec.
No worries.
I gotta turn around and look at it real quick.
Oh, do you have any coordinates?
No, I do. It's just, I'm not looking at it, so.
Oh.
Is there a way to get them through? Like, because I went into EXP3.
I was saying, look for, look on your HSI if you have the coordinates, and you'll see at the top, you'll see data.
I hit data for the
Alright,
my bad, I didn't realize that. Alright, yeah, no, you ready to copy?
Yep.
Alright, it's gonna be, 36?
36.
07?
07.
23?
23.
26.
North. Yeah. Yep.
It's gonna be
5-5-0. 0.
No. 4-3.
4-3.
0-9. West.
0-9.
Yep. West.
Oh wait. One second. All I got was 5-0-4-3-0-9.
Oh, sorry. It was a 5-2-0.
Here, one second. 5-2-0.
4-3-0-9.
09.
Yep, there you go.
Alright, and west?
Yeah. Elevation is going to be, if you want to put it in, 364. I don't know if you need it.
Oh, yeah. Appreciate it.
Yeah, nice. That's the one I didn't drop any bombs on.
Investigate that one.
Roger. My harm might have hit that one, though. I'm not, 100% sure.
Yeah. So, 40 miles from that one. Damn, I just got a full master warning, 9.2.
Yeah, I'm at 7.0 right now.
You're not in full burners or anything, right? Like, if you're...
No.
Or not full burners, but not even, minimum burn. You're probably... If you're just orbiting I'm area, you're probably going to want to just maintain, 0.7 Mach or so.
Yeah, I'm at full mil right now.
All right. Might be able to get away with a little bit less than full mil, just enough to keep you in flight, if you're in a safe zone.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah. Because you're just going to be burning minimal gas, just to stay in the area.
Yeah, I'll pull it back even more. I didn't realize. I thought you'd burn more at a lower power setting up here. Alright, there we go.
I think that's the hiding spot of my guy that I'm looking for.
Oh!
Yes. Yes, you are right. That is him. I think that is him.
Alright.
Okay. Talent 3-1. 301 is gonna start my attack run. I'm about 2 minutes out.
Copy that. Best of luck.
Oh, geez. And I'm going to be escaping off to the northwest.
Roger. I'm just still circling. I'm 50 miles out from target. Oh man. Best of luck, Doc. Oh, man.
Yeah, escaping those Ziggin and Zaggin.
Roger.
It's gonna be close, I think. separation. Actually, 500 feet.
Roger.
A minute and a half out from my one. Seconds.
Roger.
Ten seconds. Zero-one, bomb's gone.
Roger.
Going to be, looking for ya.
Roger, you should see me right off your nose. We are, closing at each other at about 1,100 knots.
Oh, yeah. Oh, damn, you're hauling booty. 0.9 Mach. What's your fuel state?
I'm not even, 5.9, but... I'm less than full mil, so I don't know.
It's not less enough.
Yeah, right. I'll still make it back. I'll be fine.
You can probably start turning too if you wanted to.
Roger, I'm gonna start turning. Yeah, it's gonna be close.
Yeah.
Roger, I'm far am I away from the ship? 213 miles away from the ship.
About 20 miles behind you.
Roger.
Oh man.
Yeah, 5.7. It's gonna be interesting. It's certainly going to be interesting.
At best, I can make it back with 4,500 pounds. I think I'm gonna burn for 3,000 pounds, though.
See what I can make it back with. At best, I can make it back with 4,000. Good enough for me. I'm gonna keep my power setting here. I'm in first stage burners at Angels 3-3.
175, I think, was reciprocal.
Yep. Was.
Nautical miles.
I'm hanging out at 33. Got your spike? Bingo.
I just got it as you said that. 0-1, bingo fuel. Yeah, we should be good though. Easy day. It's gonna get an easy trap.
Yeah. That's the hope. I'm holding on to that hope.
Oh, you're probably below contrail.
I might be. Almost Mach 1, not quite there. 0.98.
Wow. 0.96.
Nice. You full burners?
No, second stage, I think.
I would slow down a little bit, but my fuel isn't gonna let me do that.
Oh, you are actually contrailing. Yeah, I see you.
I am or I'm not?
Yeah, you are.
Oh, okay.
I spotted you. About 20 minutes till we're on deck. If we don't bolter or anything, it's 1/16th mile visibility.
Don't jinx me, Doc. What are you doing?
How much fuel are you gonna have when you get there?
4,500. So I'll have plenty.
Oh, okay, yeah.
My commencement, though, that's when. Probably gonna scare the shit out of me again. I'm gonna go to outside view, look behind me, and you're just gonna be inverted on my tail fins. Every time you do that, I'm like, I'm never expecting it. So I look outside and I just see your jet right there, and I'm like, oh! Like, shit. Our fuel is very on edge. I like to live dangerously. I have a supersonic, I'll be there in 3 seconds. That's right.
I am dangerous.
Yeah. Oh, God. Awkward part of the whole movie. That one scene right there. Are you with me?
Maybe.
Oh yeah, you are.
Sorry, there's not but, enough energy up here, so you do it effectively. How you doing?
You're doing it though. You are doing it. Back to home sweet home.
Yeah.
Home ship home.
Maybe about 10 more minutes or so. That's been... That was some pretty cool teamwork with that last freaking SAM site that we killed. Maybe the coordinates that I killed. Let's see if there's one left. There's four out there, but there's apparently parts from one that are still out there, but
Took it out. Sorry.
I'm always looking at attack view.
Yeah. I'm actually really curious to watch the tag view tonight.
Ship heading,
I was about to ask, is it heading towards us?
No, it's heading from north to south, so from right to left.
Okay.
Relative to us.
Roger.
What's your hot fuel state?
Good question. 5.0.
Wow. 3.6.
Oh, damn. You ended up getting lower than me.
Yeah. I had to do that last bomb run.
Yep. What are you looking at when you get there?
Oh, freaking 2.5.
Oh, man, not bad.
Easy day.
Easy day. Be a nice light trap.
Yeah.
Probably keep your speed at what? Like one run 120 at that.
Yeah.
At that weight, right?
Yes. Nice slow trap. Nice gentle. Yeah. As gentle as Navy traps can get.
Yeah. Still gonna catch a one.
Still gonna catch a one. Oh my gosh. If I catch a one.
Full burner it off of the ship.
I will.
Oh no.
I don't know what I'll do. If I catch one wire, I'll use exclusively a scope pistol for the next rescue mission. Pilot.
Oh yeah. That's all you're gonna use, just a scope pistol.
Yeah, I'll have to exclusively use a scoped pistol.
I'm about to crash on purpose just so I can see that.
No, it doesn't matter what for you. I'm gonna have to be the one that gets someone.
No, I know. In order for you to rescue someone, though, I was gonna say I want to crash on purpose.
We gotta rescue A-10 anyways. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right. I totally forgot about that. We gotta rescue Death Pony.
Yeah.
Let's see. Someone joined the game, but I'm not sure who it is. If he has tag back, we're kind of fucked. We don't. No god. Any fuel to dogfight.
Yeah. Brent Parrish.
We get new people every day.
Yeah.
Like you said, we could have sold it to some people already. So awesome. I can't believe Donut fucking donated $10 the other day. That was awesome.
Oh man, yeah.
Yesterday.
Why is it? Is my chat not working? Our Archer was saying that chat wasn't working or something.
Oh shit, and on stream?
Yeah, I'm gonna refresh it. And see if that does anything.
Roger. Roger. Okay, I see it. Up to my left.
Oh, dang. Okay, so yeah, I'm, yeah, I got, I guess chat's working now. I see ARC Trooper's message. What up, man? Dang, yeah, I guess it was not working. I don't know how many people I missed then. Shoot, my bad. Let's see what that is.
Oh, saw the weather. Left.
Yeah.
I'm gonna commence at about 30 miles, Doc.
Roger. Gotta sit out. 50.
Yeah, about probably 2 more minutes.
To snag some gas real quick before I trap after you commence.
Red. I don't have any flares, or else I'd give you a goodbye flare.
You're out of them?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm not sure how many I have left. I should probably check that.
Might be something I should learn how to do. I don't even know how to check if I have
flares. I have left 19 flares.
Nice.
You're
305 is commencing. Oh, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Talon 301 is fuel low. Yeah, the chat wasn't working. Yeah, or it wasn't showing up on dashboard. Donut's chat showed up earlier.
Yeah. Alan, 305 is platform 4.3. On 305, it's 20 miles, hook down. I think I made my platform call it wrong. Platform is 5K, right?
Yeah, 5,000.
Oh, okay. Yeah. What do I say at 10? I don't say anything at 10,000, do I?
Nah, no.
Then I messed that up. I set a brain fart right there. Sorry. Now, 305 platform, 4.2. Here we go.
It doesn't matter, though. If you're descending fast enough, it's close enough for government work.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
6 miles from the tanker.
Roger.
Actually about 7, or about 7. About 6.
There's that cloud there. There it is. Helm 305 is 1,200 feet.
Yeah, it it goes into OBS probably, but yeah, I don't really look at OBS. Yeah, I'm just looking over at dashboard usually.
Man, can't see nothing at night from outside view. Not a damn thing.
There he is. I just spotted him in the last second.
That tanker.
Nice. How much you get? What are you topping off at?
Probably only like 3,000 pounds or 3 or 4.
Roger.
I need to go ahead and go nose cold. Lights on there, you can barely see that tanker.
Yeah. But.
Talon 310 is switch to safe nose cold, looking for 4K. Huh. Oh, okay. Well, Talon 310 has received fuel. Freaking... Second.
Were you not receiving fuel for a minute there?
No, I was. It's just that I wasn't in a true virtual cockpit. I was in a VRS virtual cockpit, so the drogue disappeared a lot sooner than expected.
Right. Is 10 miles, fly left, or needles, fly left, fly up. Whew. Here we go, Doc. Here we go. Easy track tonight.
I'm not doing bad, ARC Trooper. How about you? My bad. More attention there. So I have a bunch of PIOs out of nowhere. Pilot induced oscillations. Yeah, I'll probably be topping off about 6,000.
Right.
Yeah, I'll go up to max trap weight, 8,000. Might as well go back
up to that team. I'm, dropping low. On this approach by accident.
Yeah.
Sorry, no worries. Still gonna get the bird down. Down 305 is 5 miles down and dirty.
PSI and everything while I'm watching this. Oh, okay, cool. So actually, now once he turns back around, I'll probably break off of him.
Roger.
Come on. Should have gotten all that prep beforehand. The 310 is or 301 is disconnecting. Continue. Going aft.
Roger. On 305, Rhino Clara, 3.3. On centerline, on glide slope.
Yeah, I appreciate you letting me know, man. It's sometimes, yeah, because I only usually am watching dashboard chat. Not my OBS chat. Yeah, it was not showing up on, darn, yeah, I probably missed a lot of, messages. I'm hoping Donut didn't, yeah, damn, I bet Donut was getting ignored, too. So, shit. My bad. I'll have to hit him up. Is commencing 22 miles.
Crap, two wire red deck.
Nice. I'm close enough to 20 miles for government work, so I'm gonna go ahead and drop my hook. What are they gonna do? Fire me?
They wouldn't fire you, Doc. One of the best pilots in the world.
That was a joke in the military. It was your contract. You're like hoping they would fire you, you know.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Because, hey, then I get to go be a civilian again. 301 platform 6.7.
Roger.
Should be able to get this.
Oh, okay. Okay, I believe you. Okay.
Let's see. Yeah, Donut was in there chatting earlier.
Might have missed him.
Yeah. got distracted. Yeah, I need to...
Uh-oh. Bad approach?
Yeah. See if we can't do something.
You going around?
Maybe.
Maybe. Still got time to correct?
Ah, sure, yeah, this is not in parameters. I'm just gonna go around. I could have easily right. had it, but.
Yeah.
I was trying to bleed off my airspeed all at once, but.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to go around.
Yeah, there's your burners. I see them off in the distance.
Back off to the north.
Roger.
Bingo. Bingo.
Oh my god. No, I can't say it. You gotta wait till the stream's over.
Down and dirty yet?
Roger.
I thought I swore I put my hook down earlier. So it somehow got put back up.
This tisk tisk.
I'm on a glide slope now.
Roger. Got 30 knots over the deck, Doc.
Roger. Gosh, no.
What'd you get?
I'm ashamed to admit it. I don't even want to say.
A one wire?
It's a two wire.
Oh, man.
Jeez. I've been getting like a lot of two wires recently. Like, I used to... wires is one. Yeah, you can't spot the ball or anything, so it's all off the needles.
Yeah.
Oh, man. But I think I'm gonna call it a night here.
Attack view.
Yeah, appreciate. Oh, okay, yeah. I will, are we, yeah, okay, cool. I'm gonna kill
close the server. Yeah.
And we'll take a look at the attack view.
Alright.
Where's the webcam stuff? There's that. Attack view. Let's put that up. Up. That's kind of weird how it shows the background of OBS. But, let's take a look here. This is before we started. We're inbound right here. First, I went out forward, I think. Yeah, let's see here.
Yeah, you went out ahead.
Yeah. Where's my EGM88C? Oh, okay, I've already shot one. Alright, yeah, so there I go. Out to line abreast. I'm gonna fire one of these. That's where that goes. That was a good hit on one of them.
Yep.
Let's see, my second. That one hit the same CM site. I'm not sure if that was mine or yours.
I think that was mine. Mine did hit the one that yours hit.
Ah. Actually, I think that might have been mine too. Mine is. So oh, there goes shit. Another one. We got all three of those CM sites, it looks like, pretty easily. Yeah, you your bombs hit pretty hard, close too, it looks like. Take a look at the bomb here. That does appear to be pretty darn close to a direct hit. I'm gonna take a look at my first bomb. Oh, here goes mine. Alright, yeah, mine put it in roughly the area of in between several of them.
Yeah. That little empty spot there.
Yeah. There's that active one over there. That's the one that was giving us all the problems later.
Oh, yeah. The one that's not with the group.
Yeah.
Yep.
Boom. Yep. That got that. So, is this SAM's site? All that was remaining was apparently two launchers, it looks like. We'll take a look, though, at my last GBU.
Roger.
Here's the one that you gave me coordinates for.
Yep.
Well, actually,
then we'll take a look at the,
let's
take a look at the missile dodges.
Yeah. We'll take a look at that right now, actually. There goes my horns again. There goes one of your missiles. Here you are.
Dumping out flare and chaff to save my life.
You still. Nice, you're changing directions back across it. It's a direction of travel, giving it more. Oh man.
Close, isn't it?
Let's see.
I knew it was close. That thing was changing direction on me so freaking quick.
But yeah, I think that saved your life though, changing that last little zag right there.
Yeah.
You zagged when you should have zagged. And that's why you survived. Let's see how close that came.
Oh,
one
man.
Thing, though, I might recommend, though, at that point, that far out, be flying more away than down, Like, it's good to get your energy up by diving, but at the same time, that missile, I think you could have outran had you, had it been, whatchamacallit,
just running directly away, and...
Yeah, well, exactly. That one was pretty close. We'll take a look at this one, too. We'll see if any of them came close. I don't think I had any that close.
Well, that last one you said was pretty close.
Yeah, we'll take a look. Yeah, see how I'm like... My tactic is essentially when I'm... So I'm getting a missile warning here. That's when I drop my bomb. I am diving temporarily. So yeah, I'm passing their Angels 35. There's the missile right there coming up for me. But see how I'm pointing my ass into it? For the most part, I'm leveling out. Because I know that missile's going to have to climb up further, you know, to get to me. So I'm kind of trying to burn out energy. If I dive, though, then it can dive with me, you know. And it's going to maintain its energy if it's diving. Now, it's not a bad idea if you want to, if you have enough space between you and the missile to run it into the ground or something like that. You know, there's definitely... times to do it, you know, or definitely would be appropriate, but in this case, see how every time I do that turn, see how it has to go back into a lead pursuit, so now I'm coming back across its beam again, and now if it wants to continue to track me, it's going to have to keep on doing more and more lead pursuits on my jet. So all I had to really do, if you watch like a top-down view of that, as it's coming in, watch how as I switch direction back over to the left, left turn, this missile's going to have to zag its way back into a lead pursuit on me. So there it goes. And now that it's zagged that way, now I want to zag it the other way. You know?
Right. Okay.
And so I'm crossing its beam again. I'm not zigging and zagging like in a direction that's going to still be able to intercept me. I keep on crossing over. Almost like I'm trying to draw a line of stitches for it to fly through, if that makes sense. Right. But yeah, at that point, that missile is defeated. At that point, it's, I'm already flying faster than it away.
Okay.
Well, we'll see if we got another dodge here. Yeah, but you're in Dodge City.
Oh, yeah.
Now, there goes another one. Oh, okay, so this is the last one at GBU. Strike. So there I go again. See, put it back into a left turn, going right back into the right turn. We're going to try to zag it again, or zig it again.
Yep.
But really, at that point, I think I'm safe, so I'm not even bothering. I'm just wanting to get the hell away from it.
Right.
Take a look at my bomb, though, here. Yeah, there is the SAM site.
Nice.
Let's see how good of a hit this was. Oh, man. Yeah, that was a precision strike. I mean, it wasn't a direct hit on anything, but I'm sure that was... Look how... Yeah. That was a mountain that was on the side of, apparently. But
Are
all destroyed. That was more than enough. That was
nice.
Close enough. They say it's close enough for horseshoes and hand grenades and JDAM 2,000 pound bombs, I guess.
Good stuff, Doc. Good strike.
Yeah, it's pretty good, I think. Oh, shoot. We should probably take a look at Death Ponies.
Oh, yeah. Totally forgot he was in there.
We'll take a look at the initial.
Yep.
Ooh, okay, so right here, we can even see it on the side menu, like how it started firing off the SAMs. Yep, there goes two of them. It shot right off the bat. Let's see if we can get labels on here. Oh, okay, so there they are. owns it. He probably doesn't have an RWR warning. What's up?
He unfortunately did get hit.
Yeah. I'm not sure which one of these got him, though. I'm kind of wondering how far away he was from the... Oh, he's about 20 miles. Yeah. He said he was about 20 miles. He was at 3,000 feet. Oh, no. Those look very threatening. That does appear to be a warranty avoiding missile for the Fairchild Republic. Man, that one came close, that first one. Here comes the second one.
Yeah, he said he dodged that one.
See, at that point, see how that missile's already subsonic?
Yep.
Oh, he dodged that one, too. There goes three more. It just launched three more at him.
They were hungry for him.
Yeah. He dodged three. Oh, there goes a fourth one. Fourth one's in there. Oh, dang. Yeah, those, like I said, those sands are already subsonic by the time they,
Right.
This one's not subsonic. He's close enough now where they're coming in pretty fast. Ooh! Oh!
Oh, shit.
There's debris falling off the aircraft. It's out of control, it looks like. He's doing his best to maintain control. Uh-oh, here comes another one.
That last one was a direct impact. The third one.
Oh, he dodged one while he was on fire. I guess the missile.
Oh, man.
He was doing a good job for a while, man. Dodging them, I guess.
Yeah.
But... yeah. Ooh, oh, wow.
He just got hit again, right? Yep.
Oh,
bang.
Oh, no. Ah. Yep.
Oh, missed that one. And then smack.
I think I'm the 2R bad luck in archers. Oh, yeah.
That was good, though. He's in an A-10, so.
Yeah.
And props to him. So.
Yeah. It's definitely, And it was, 1/16th mile visibility.
Yep.
No, so, my first approach, yeah, I was, looking at chat and everything. Like, not paying any attention.
Got distracted and elated.
Yeah, I was distracted and elated, so I'm coming in here, like, 500 knots. I'm like, oh, I'm only, like, 2 miles from the ship. So I thought, like, oh, I can maybe, like, slow it down real quick if I just, like...
Yeah.
Porpoising a bunch, but no. Too little, too late.
Yeah.
I mean, granted, I got down to, you know, somewhat, I could have probably trapped it, but no.
Sorry.
Decided to try to be the adult and mature thing. Go around. But yeah, the second one didn't. Is bad. The approach didn't look bad. I would have liked to have gotten the 3-wire though.
Yeah, it's alright.
Well, I appreciate anyone tuning in. I'm probably gonna call it a stream here. Yeah, nah. Thanks for flying with us, Death Pony, if you're watching. Or if you catch us on YouTube or anything. We'll be back up tomorrow again for a more normal stream where we can see the ship. But, yeah, like I said, thanks for anyone tuning in, and, until next time, happy flying.